these grading Pokemon card returns. Also, I just went out for food like an hour ago, so my stomach is like acting really weird, and I don't know why it does this, but my stomach growls after I eat food rather than before. So, yeah, apologies if that annoys you. So, if I open this, there is just a lot of graded Pokemon cards in here. So, let's take a look. Okay. Card number one is the worst of the bunch. This got graded a 6. I have no idea why. Sometimes that happens, but the rest of them are like, okay. So, moving on, we've got some really old cards. These cards are almost as old as me. These are from 2000. The year 2000. Team Rocket Charmander. That's a 7. Oh, that's my stomach. We've got an 8. Tyranitar. Which is newer, that's from 2022. And then an 8 Blastoise, also from 2022. Ace grading recently changed the slabs, which is the case that it's held in. And to be honest, I'm not a fan. The old ones felt much more sturdy. They were bigger and thicker, and they stacked really well. Whereas these don't stack very well. So disappointed, but you know, there's my stomach again. We've got another 8 Blissey V. So there might be a few 8s in a row here. There's another one of those Charmanders in an 8 this time. I believe I have another one of those as well. I think I do. Got another one. We've got a Weavile at 8. My stomach is just... Style mustard, which is a trainer card, and then this is one of my favorite cards from this set. We have a VMAX Climax Umbreon, which sadly got a 9, not the 10, but amazing card, looks so cool. An Arceus. Charizard, which got a 9. Again, disappointed I don't get the 10, but we've got a 9. And then we've got a Zacian 9 and a Mimikyu 9. Something like 38-39% of the cards I sent off came back as 10s, which is not too bad. So this time we got the Charizard 10, so that's very cool. There we go. And we got a Zapdos 10 as well. These Japanese cards always get 9s and 10s, man. A Rockruff. A Jolteon. A Kingdra 10 as well. Cool artwork. Aerodactyl. Boom. The camera's doing a good job of focusing today, actually. Usually it's pretty bad. And now we have the Giratina V-Star 10. And the last card, which is the best one, I got the Giratina V-Star Hyper Rare Gem Mint 10. This card right now is on eBay for like £70 to £90 GBP, which is like almost $100 US for one card. So happy with this one. It's super cool. It's got like a textured effect on there, grainy effect, rainbow, shiny, glitter, everything. So, that is my ace grading Pokemon card returns, although I believe I will just call this like Pokemon card collection or something, because I don't think the ASMR community really knows what ace grading is. Okay, I'm going to try and be neat with this, because I had to cut. Because I just dropped all of the cards on my desk. So we're going to try and put this one in neatly. There we go. I have like thousands of cards and then graded cards I have like maybe 120 to 150, but I have shown quite a lot of them off before, so although this isn't like my true first Pokemon collection video, I think we'll just call it Pokemon collection. I did get a ton of code cards, so it's like just lots of code cards, which you get every time you open a pack. There's so many boxes of them. I mean, I don't think I've shown off this box yet. These aren't graded, but there's another box here, which is also just full of cards. So like, there's all sorts in here. There's a Superior V, Omnistar V, a Hisuian Arcanine V. There's a Milotic Trainer card. That's a cool one. A Bronzong. Starmie. So there's all sorts. We've got an Iscan trainer. Yeah, there's just so much in here. was a king dress that I had graded. So, and I'm still waiting on like another, I think, 21 cards to come back graded. So, yep, I'm still waiting on some. So probably another one of these at some point in the next few weeks. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, comment, all that stuff that every YouTuber asks you to do. Although I think I like to study the YouTube algorithm and things and know what's going on. I'm pretty sure that the only thing YouTube cares about is watch time. So it's just like how much of the video somebody has watched influences how much more it's going to get recommended. So like if I had 100 people watching this video and they all watched the full thing, YouTube would be like, this video is good, let's recommend it to another 100 people and another one. And that's how you end up with a video that has like 50,000 to 100,000 views and, you know, yeah. So, but everyone asks for the likes and the comments and subscribes anyway, so we do that too. Alright, yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this Pokemon video, and I will see you next time.